You might not think that a narcissist really wants to be around anyone, given the way they act. They often seem to be annoyed by the people to whom they are close. Moreover, they often seem to lack the ability to commit to a long-term relationship. As a result, they typically marry several times over the course of their lifetime. So, just why do narcissists get married in the first place? If you're considering marriage to a narcissist or know someone who is, you really want to read more about their underlying agenda. Let's explore these 7 reasons why a narcissist might want to get married so you can be fully informed about their true intentions. A secure source of narcissistic supply. Narcissists don't have a healthy sense of identity. They have constructed a false self-image and infused it with grandiose ideas about their superiority. But that false ego can't support those delusions of grandeur. The narcissist needs other people to do that for them. They need an almost constant supply of adoration to maintain their false ego. This is called narcissistic supply. And what better source than a spouse for that constant praise? Narcissists expect their spouses to always put their needs first and to always sing their praises to their friends and family members. Failing to do so will get you a heaping helping of narcissistic rage. They also don't return the favor. They are often unwilling to recognize their spouse's good qualities or talents. To them, their spouse's role in the marriage is to support them, while their role is to shine. Familial acceptance. Aside from fulfilling society's expectations, the narcissist seeks to show their family how great they are and how irresistible they are, too. The narcissist is not just trying to prove their worth to strangers in the broader culture, they are also proving themselves to their family. This is particularly true if the narcissist is a product of parental rejection and neglect. If their parents were constantly critical of them as a child, a common cause of narcissism, then they may be trying to earn their parents' respect. Sometimes the childhood trauma that has caused narcissism is a reason why the narcissist is always trying to prove themselves to their family. They may be pushing back against feelings of inadequacy generated by overly critical or neglectful parents. They may be screaming out for attention from the people who abused them in childhood. This is a common result in abusive situations, as psychiatrists and neuroscientists have shown with research conducted in 2010. Their work details the problems with attachment that occur as a result of maltreatment in childhood. In fact, this type of early childhood abuse even alters the genetic expression of certain genes associated with behavioral outcomes. It just goes to show how damaging this kind of abuse can be. The effects can easily last a lifetime. Image protection. Above all else, the narcissist wants to protect their image. They have spent a long part of their childhood constructing a grandiose image of who they want to believe themselves to be. It's easy to see that traumatized inner child compensating for the shame and self-loathing their childhood experiences have caused. The image they produce is one of superiority and perfection. It's a coping mechanism to provide them with the perfect self-image in place of their damaged true self. They then proceed to manipulate people around them to validate that false self-image. Anything that threatens that false self-image also threatens to expose the truth about the narcissist. They threaten to expose their damaged nature. Such exposure would create a mental breakdown known as a narcissistic collapse. That's why they take whatever steps are necessary to promote their false self-image. This includes marrying the right person and marrying them quickly. they feel a heightened need to protect their image by doing whatever they have come to believe is consistent with the unrealistic image they've created of themselves. Fear of abandonment. The narcissist's insecure attachment style makes them fear the loss of loved ones through abandonment. At a deep level, they believe themselves to be inherently unworthy and unlovable. That's why they often marry, to secure their spouse and ensure they won't be abandoned. Occasionally, this fear shows through the narcissist's facade. My friend who's married to a narcissist has told me on more than one occasion about how panicked her husband becomes when she threatens to leave the house during an argument. While she only wants a cooling off period, he fears she won't return at all. On one occasion, there was a friend staying at their house, and when she left after a heated argument, the narcissist meekly asked her friend, "What if she doesn't come back?" The friend reassured him that she would be back. She just needed time to settle down. Of course, she did return, but it was clear he was terrified she would not. On these rare occasions, you can see that damaged child crying out in fear. It doesn't justify their behavior, but it does explain at least part of it. While the narcissist doesn't think about these strategies in a conscious manner, they are guided by their fears. They know that it would make them feel more secure if they were married. For religious purposes, another part of a structured life that helps the narcissist feel more secure is having a strong religious belief. Many narcissists are raised in abusively religious homes, and they use their religious beliefs as a foundation for structuring their world. When they are religious, they compete for God's attention as well. They want to show they are more religious than anyone else in their world, and they often tout their pious superiority in religious circles. As part of their religious beliefs, they may believe they need to marry. They might believe this is necessary in order to have sex or children. They may even see it as a commandment from God. Religious narcissists are typically as strict in their beliefs as they are in other parts of their lives. They try to convince everyone that they are holier than anyone else, while simultaneously feeling inferior on a deep level. Still, they see religion as their salvation. They use it to make themselves feel more secure. No matter who else abandons them, God will not leave them behind. They frequently become the zealots who demand that everyone conform to their belief system. They certainly expect that of their spouse. To be in the spotlight. Narcissists not only want to be in the spotlight, but they also need to be in the spotlight. They require constant external validation, and the only way they can ensure they get it is to remain in the spotlight. Marriage puts them in the spotlight when they get married, and then the narcissist can remain in the spotlight with their spouse. At least, that's what motivates the narcissist to get married. They are in the spotlight for their friends and family all the time they are planning their wedding. And of course, on their wedding day, everyone is focused on the couple. After the wedding, however, the attention fades and the narcissist turns to their spouse to continue feeling as though they are in the spotlight. It's usually not enough for the narcissist, which is also why they commonly have extramarital affairs. It creates drama in their life, another thing the narcissist loves, but it also keeps them in more than one person's spotlight. For the love of drama. Another thing a narcissist can use their marriage for is to create drama. They love to create drama in their life because it makes them feel powerful. They like knowing they can upset the apple cart and get everyone to focus on them by manipulating a dramatic situation. They will do this throughout their marriage, but they will also use divorce as a way to create drama. It also focuses their friends' attention on them as they go through a difficult stage of life. A narcissist really can't go very long without creating some kind of drama in their life. They thrive on it because it catapults them into the spotlight. Whatever situation they've contrived, they can use that to get their friends to worry about them and be focused on their life. To generate drama, they may start an argument over nothing. They will often provoke their spouse using little more than an imagined slight. Their discard of their spouse is another source of drama, as are their often multiple affairs. Finally, a narcissist has many reasons why they get married, and most are not out of love for a potential spouse. While we can't know what they really feel on the inside, it is clear that the narcissist has difficulty expressing love. They focus instead on manipulating their spouse into doing what they want. They often use their spouse's emotional triggers and old wounds to do this, and it can be very effective. You can combat this tactic, though, with my 5-step roadmap to heal emotional triggers. This free guide can help you recognize your old emotional wounds and the triggers that resulted from that early trauma. It can also help you diffuse those triggers and even heal your trauma. Just click on the link below this video, and I'll send this guide directly to your inbox. You can start on healing those wounds today and stop narcissistic abuse in its tracks. Thanks for watching.